Welcome back. This is Happening Life, the chat show with Ayame Michael, and the groups of people, key players in the grant space is getting interesting. We are ready and prepared to update you on the happening in the grant space. Pay attention to the chat show, what is going on in the grant space. Thank you for joining us. Consider to subscribe if you are new to our channel and turn on the bell for notification. Grant community is getting hot and you have to pay attention to what is happening right now. Thank you for joining us.
Mr. Lakposu, I'm sorry I'm not pronouncing the name correctly. Hello, sir, you can speak now. Mr. Lakposu.
I'm speaking. Are you hearing me? Hello?
Sir, go on.
Are you hearing me?
Yeah, go on, sir.
Okay.
We can hear you.
That's very good. I just want to contribute little. I thank God to be here this evening to put a light. I'm one of the cooperative leaders. I'm from Oyo State. I'm a prophet of God and I'm a doctor. Yeah, I thank that woman that I just spoke in. They put more light, and the other man that has spoken now. Then I'm very grateful that I had something good from the ambassador this evening, that we are still on point. But I want to talk something that is very, very important to this matter. And from Oyo State, Baba Alhaji Agidi has never collected any money from any widows. We, as a leader of cooperative, we are the one, we are like six or eight, we are the one that carry everything, even though at some point we don't collect money from any of our beneficiary. And anytime Baba Gidi Alhaji that came from Oyo State in Ibadan want to come for a program, we don't give him a damn, and he's not collecting anything from us. We have a record, we have a video, and we have an everything. And all these people, all this widow they are talking about, the Baba Alhaji Agidi promising them house and some other things without collecting anything from the widows. So, and all the houses he promising has never collect anything. So, we in Ibadan, precisely, we don't book hotel for Baba Agidi. We gathered ourselves, and he used to come to the venue. After coming to the venue, he will talk to us and he will promise us some things, and that is all. And I can tell everyone that is here, he always from morning to the evening. I have to be there many times. He's sitting down, even though presently, as he's in the Uyu, he opened a platform for all the prophet of God that we should be praying on that platform for to you company and the others, both home and away, to support the vision of the capital. So that is just it. But I want to ask Ambassador a question. As you said that no one will return the money, whether little or small, when we are registered. Is it truly by June we are getting what they are promising and what we deserve? I see it as a benefit. We just want to hear from you, sir. I'm very happy to know you today and to have a tangible words from you, sir. God bless you.
I am a can ask you.
Yeah, madam.
Yeah.
What's all right?
They are emphasizing on widows.
Hello, good evening.
But my point still remains that
Hello,
can you hear me?
Go on, man. I'm sorry. Comrade Abe, hold on.
My point is that me, I'm not talking about widows alone. I'm not pointing fingers at widows. What me I'm talking about is that what he promised the people, like as it is, the NGOs, he promised them, or is it the coordinators, he promised them 20M. And in the process of the empowerment. There are some people that maybe an artisan that comes out during that time, they will declare that this person win Okada, this zone win a tractor, and then the processing fee. That is what I'm talking about. Processing fee for all those things. And as it is, they are just saying that he didn't collect money from widows. Even though he didn't collect money direct from widows, processing fee for each 1M is 1,000, which he cannot dispute. So he has some list of processing fee for every of the things, of which the NGOs and the cooperative, they will submit money in their office. They will submit money in their office. So what we are talking about now, when are they going to respond to the people? Because the people are dragging the coordinators in their zones. So we want to, because in the general platform, they are not communicating with the NGOs. It's only prayer, but they are not telling the NGOs the position of things. So coming up to tell us another thing here, we should not cover whatever anybody does. We are here to correct each other. So there should be a correction on that. They should let us know the position of things. And I still stand on my words that we need to invite the general in Uyo to come and tell us what is on in this project.
Thank you, ma. Thank you.
Let me say something. Sorry, sir. Mr. Kaya Day, Sunday. Please, we don't need a video staff here. Please, can you off that for us, please? Mr. Kaya Day, Sunday. Off your video recording, sir. All right, Mr. Comrade Abi. Comrade Abi. Abu. Mr. Abu, you have a question to ask. Comrade Abi.
Yes, sir.
Well, go on.
Yeah, good evening, everyone. I think the problem, what caused this a problem, is the delay. I think I was privileged to be part of the program sometimes maybe about 3 years ago now. When the issue of AGE came up last year, I was there with Baba. But what matter most is they didn't keep, people informed. So at least the periodic information to the people, we didn't forget you. But this is what we are facing now. In the next few months or week, we'll get back to you. So periodic information is what most matter most. And then when I was there that last year, I asked Baba, he said something. And I don't know, maybe this happens to other cooperative owners or NGO. He said, because people were unable to just go to Hajj that last year, and some people were complaining. And Baba used to say, did I collect any money from you? I didn't collect. Hajj is free. Jerusalem is free. So I didn't collect any money from you. That I've told those people that brought you, that is the NGOs and the cooperatives, that they should not collect any money from you, that it is free. Then some NGOs made it to just difficult for some people. I got to know Baba through Mrs. Solanke, our princess here, that is talking, and I was a coordinator of my town then. So Baba said that majority of the NGO owners, they were the one collecting money from people. That Baba said they asked every NGO that the people that will be gathered in any hall or any place of event must not more than about 20 or 30 people. So he said that the NGOs are the ones that made this program to just be a force or a scam. But what I want to ask now is, I want to ask Ambassador, can you people hear me? Hello,
sir. We can hear you.
So I want to ask.
We can hear you, sir. Go on.
I want to ask Ambassador. It should be very, very good and okay for Baba himself to be on this seat just to clear himself in some allegations leveled against him. I'm not the one to speak for him. That's one. Then, according to what Princess of Sri Lanka said tonight, that the petition they wrote to the headquarter, I think the thing is contradicting themselves. The information they got from Hiyo and the one in Ibadan. So I would like Mr. Michael and Ambassador to just carry Baba along over this matter for Baba to just clear himself to the general public. So that's my submission.
All right, thank you very much. Mr. Abu, please. Abu, you can speak now, sir. Mr. Abu. Hello, sir. All right, Mr. Abu.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you.
According to the last speaker, I'm very impressed with what he said. See, this thing is very simple. What the other madam was saying, that they should invite the person from the headquarters, you cannot just rise. Let's try to be factual here and face reality. Fine, this is just like a platform that want to do justice to people that were cheated or something. Fine, I like it, but you cannot just rise anybody. If there is any investigation that he is interested, or anybody, whoever is interested in knowing the fact, the truth about this empowerment program, you are free. There's a website for to your organization. Anybody can go there. It's an address at the office in Uyo, which is the headquarters. They can go there and make their inquiries. Do you understand, sir? They can easily go there, make your inquiries. Ask people there. Mm. You will see the country head there. Me, I've been there once, just to make sure that I know what I'm doing. Okay, see now. I'm very sorry if this will affect anybody. Look at the UAAG, for example. Look at Theobarth. Fine. The same thing is happening. I don't know whether it is the government that is holding down the development of anything. But fact, all these things, it's going that want to be done, is going to be more than billions. In line that with 4 to 3 years. So it's not just a small money that is in the Ghana must go back of anybody's backyard. They have to be processed. It will go through a lot of process. But according to him, from what Baba has told me, from what I learned from him, he said everything will not pass this June. That is the latest. Then from there, if nothing happens, we'll take the next step. Okay, Baba, what's happening? This is what he said. Because we have waited so long, like just a few months, to be just be making unnecessary noise. I could make noise myself if I want to. But I want to see it to the end of what he has said. So just have little patience and be civilized in what we are doing. And actually, I've been to so many program offices. Most of these so-called NGO leaders and all these cooperative leaders extort their beneficiaries. This man will come and do program for you once and leave. You will be continuing to be calling your people demanding some tokens from them. Do you understand? So maybe those people, those their beneficiaries are disturbing them. Okay, for instance, they were talking about the man want to send some people to Jerusalem or Hajj. It did not work out. But he did not collect one naira from you, from anybody. I was involved. One naira, he did not collect. Just 50 naira, I did not collect. Let me say that. It's just a promise that it did not work out as promised. And he has promised that probably this year, if not all the people you promised, at least the rational 10% or 20% might be benefited from it. So I just plead and everybody that is involved to just have little patience of 2-3 months. It is so short that more than how many years, 3 years or 2 years I've been waiting. I'm involved with UAAG. I've been waiting for donkey years. Nothing happened up to now. All right. Please, I'm just pleading.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Yeah.
All right. Do we have anybody that want to ask question? Or the ambassador, do you have anything to say to those questions, sir?
All right, thank you. I want to thank everyone for their submission, especially the princess. You know, she has the feeling for my, that's why she has spoken that way. And my brother that talked, you know, before my other brothers just that spoke lastly, he said something, he said the delay, that is what is bringing out all this. And for most of us, if we know the ambassador very well, he's a passionate person. Is not all these things that we are seeing that is happening, that has delayed to this moment, is not his own, is not his willing. He's someone that he said how, when last did he see his family? You know, we can't just be saying all this on air. It will look as if maybe we are trying to be on the side of the ambassador. No, but you see, an ambassador is one kind of person that he looks for solution. You know what's the way out, and the joy of this whole thing is that because we have crossed most of these orders, you know, I wish this kind of talk is coming before now. Maybe there will be that anxiety or that fear that hope will it work out or will it not. But I'm giving you, like I've said, is it when we already have a solution at hand or we already have the sources at hand, there's no need beating behind the bush. Everybody are only talking, you know, based on what is happening in the country, along with what is happening in the ecosystem, you know, in the grant ecosystem, which we quite understood their feelings. But we can show you that this is a good project, quite different from every other project. One of the best projects that has happened to this country. And by God's grace, it will come to limelight. So please, just bear with us. You'll be, if you say you'll bear, like somebody said 2012, though I'm not aware of that, or this whole age of a thing was just recent. Maybe last year was our first attempt, you know. And then, you know, this year we're still looking at, okay, what can we do with the issue of inflation of the dollar and all these things. But the good part of it is that we have something at hand, and which, you know, is coming up very soon. That's why we say that June, July, by God's grace, you will see, even before then, you will start seeing all these things, you know, coming to limelight. And as regards the information, since you said we should be at least keep people abreast, let them have, you know, information, updates about how.
Hello, sir.
Hello.
Yeah. Hello, okay. You want to say something? Yeah, I'll tell you.
Say something in conclusion to this meeting. The conclusion to this meeting is that everyone has said the little that they know. But I will conclude this way, that all the coordinators that are under me, the proof of payment paid to Baba's account, come for proof of payment and follow up your state very well. That is my take. If he is proving that he did not collect kobo from anybody, then we will prove to him that we have our evidence of collecting money from us. Thank God we kept our record well. So, all the state coordinators that is in this forum, come for the evidence of payment and fight your fight very well.
Sorry, ma'am, you are saying...
I will not answer. now. Sorry to but I will need to defend the people that are out there, because we as an NGO and I will talk for myself alone. We as an NGO, we brought people and we have our coordinators all over the place. For example, myself, I have about 17 zones. And to my surprise, Baba took out of the 17 zone, 19 zone, and diverted it to my coordinators that we are together, breaking the breach of relationship. And that is one of the reasons why I'm angry. So he break the breach of relationship and started dealing with the coordinators direct. So telling them I didn't do the processing, I didn't submit money of processing to them, to him. So now as it is, since everything has come to light now, which we are just warming up, let it come to light very well. Then we will know who is lying and we will know who is telling the truth. So because the coordinators already, they are taking it that they scam them. They collect money from them, processing this thing. Everything has his own documents and account. To be fair, widows did not pay anything, but they paid for processing to the coordinators, of which we submitted, because if they promise them on the like the people that are in the zone, they call them is it escorts? They are 25. They promise there is an amount that they promise them, and there's a fee, processing fee that is accrued to it. So, of which we submitted to Baba. So, what is here, what I'm going to say in this part is that all the coordinators that are here present, just let us see behind the scene. Then, every evidence will be released and we'll take it up from there. Me, I'm not going to, because even me myself has answered, but I must not answer completely like that, because I am the one that took the people there. It's not the people that knows him. So going behind to deal with them direct, then it means he wants to continue with them. So I have to submit to them so that we know, they will know the position of things. So that's my take. Thank you.
Thank you, ma. Thank you, ma. But please, I will still want you to at least have a little understanding with Alaji. That's the ambassador. You know when you say you have 17 stones?
Then we take it.
You know, you say you have them.
There's already.
Hello, ma.
Lay down. I would just want to go out.
Hello, ma. Ma.
Before we take the tender.
Okay, ma. Ma, I'm still referring to what you said, ma. You said you have 17 zones, and to my own best of knowledge, you put them under, you know, this each zone. You use a coordinator to represent each zones, and which they also belongs to the group, that's the state group where they had their empowerment. And to me, each state coordinator will represent his zone, not that you representing this zone, the second zone, in up to the 17th. I think that's where you were getting this whole thing wrong. Baba would not have caught you. No, he wouldn't do that. He's not that kind of person. So, but I just believe that since you have those coordinators that are representing you, that's the reason why they are on that platform, and they are also getting the information, you know, to also relate. Maybe they are the one now failing to relate with you, I don't know. And secondly, you are talking about them filing up their receipts and all that.
Hello, sir. Hello, sir. I'm getting it wrong.
I'm coming, man. Let me drop the second
one. Maybe are getting
you wrap the two together, man. I just want to see the last one.
Them to bring their own organization and remove the organization name that brought those people. For example, if you have Temilola Motibo as the mother NGO, you get, then the organization said in then that they should remove the mother NGO and replace it with their own. We don't communicate again. Is the mother NGO that brought, so, and if all of them, they are coming to tell me that Baba said meet money to him, raise alarm. So if them to take over the place,
We're sorry for this network. Authority, Dr. Princess. We're sorry for the network. Yes, sir. Ambassador.
Then okay. I will need to submit to them in a proper way. Maybe through later. Hello.
Hello, ma. I can hear you, ma.
So, I need to submit and let people know what is on.
Okay, ma, because I think... All right. Okay. Yeah. Oh, ma, I believe...
Your network is bad, Ambassador. All right, Mr. Olasupo. Mr. Olasupo. Mr. Olasupo. Mr. La. Mr. Olasupo, you can speak now. Hello. All right, this is still the chat show. Thank God everything is working perfectly. But we have to close the show soon. So we have
Please,
to...
Before you close the show. Hello. Hello.
I can hear you, sir. Go on. Go on, sir.
Yeah. Good evening once again.
Yeah.
The way I understand this matter, that is clear to me very well. Yes, I'm the one again. I'm not here to defend anyone than to say the truth that we know. I'm a leader too, in your state. I'm still repeating it. Baba Alhaji Agidi is relating directly to only the leaders. Whether you are cooperative, the chairman and the secretary is relating to us directly. That is the truth of the matter. And for our own side here, and he never tells anyone what is not real or what is not right. Anyway, what I'm just saying is, all the little thing I can say is when we are registering for this something, and it's just a little, and which everybody paid. If I want to say the truth, there's nothing additional something, there's nothing special, and everything is opened. I'm a leader of the cooperative too, in your state, in Ibadan here. So there's nothing like, we don't just need to implicate ourselves unnecessarily. I don't say people should not talk, and we are talking based on what you know. But this Baba never had any complicating issue with any of the leaders, as I know and I are concerned. So that is just it. What we just need, I'm just appealing again to everybody, we have had a genuine thing from the ambassador for the first time, and he's keeping promising us that we people should wait, we people should listen to what he's saying. By June, July, even before June, July, we will get to where we are going. Please, please, as a prophet of Mosaic God, just let join hand for prayer for these people to succeed in this journey, in this place. So I'm appealing to everyone once again. The implicating the piling something up is not the matters. So Baba, many people has been saying what we know about this Baba. It's not he's putting word into our mouth. We are saying what we know about him. So, and all this issue of collecting money, collecting this, collecting that from widow, from the others, is not happening here in our state here. So that's just it. Whenever booking for pay, although we just pay little and token when we are registered. That is what I want to know. So whether we want to have another time to just meet up, Ambassador, we will continue praying for you to make things be easy for you and to succeed in this journey. I know how the people are feeling and how is concerned due to the delay and what is happening. The God will see us through and will bless us and we answered our prayer in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.
Thank you very much. Yeah. All right. Somebody want to say something? AA.
Mr. Michael.
Yes, sir.
Musa is speaking. You see, this last speaker that has spoken, in as much as I appreciate him, he is expressing his personal experience. This mother is expressing her personal experience. Nobody has a right to bring down one person and the other one. Probably this woman was not treated fine. And that is why she's expressing what she's saying. And if you, the last speaker, you were treated fine, allow the person that was not treated fine to express his grievances. This is her experience. This is your experience. The two of you cannot be the same. The right thing to do is when when he comes online, he will be the one to answer, not you pleading for him. We are humans. We are not perfect. Maybe from what I understand, some of these NGOs may have contributed a lot of things the way it is happening in the UAAG. They may go around and be extorting money. The man, you know him to be a good man. And this is the experience this other man, this woman is having. That woman cannot come here to the platform and begin to lie. And you too cannot begin to lie. If this is your experience, he's a good man, good. This is her experience. So nobody within us here can settle it. Ambassador cannot even settle it. Because ambassador is only representing him. And he has a limit to what he is saying. And from all indications, money has exchanged hands, whichever way, directly or indirectly. So please, I don't expect that in a free and fair hearing like this, the person that is involved should be the one to answer, not another person to appeal on his behalf for us to move forward. That person, the person that is complaining, is grieved because of the experience. So the madam is right to say what she is saying. And it's like ambassador is saying, it didn't happen, money was not exchanged. And she said she's going to provide receipts.
All right.
If things like this are happening, we should be fair. We should have a fair playing ground. This is her experience. This is your experience. Because you have been treated fine does not mean everybody is treated fine. If the woman was treated fine, she wouldn't have complained. Please, this is why I want to bring our notice to you. Thank you.
Hello, sir.
All right, thank you very much. Yeah, hey, ambassador.
Yeah, thank you. Please, thank you, sir, for your comments, sir. I really appreciate that too. But, sir, I never said what madam was saying was not right. You know,
I'm not talking about you, the last person that spoke.
She talked about issue of collecting money from widows, and that was why I said nothing of such. And but if there's anything, any proof to that maybe we don't pay money for anything or Jerusalem or whatever, she can make provision. But she has been able to, you know, pinpoint to what's paying that, and she just explained to me, which I think we'll look into that. Because like I said, and like the other man said, most coordinators represent their zones. So maybe perhaps something there, you know, and went wrong in that regards, maybe misinformation, whichever way. But madam, like what I was trying to say, ma, is that now we are just at the crossroad, and you're referring to issue of coming up with receipts and all that. Are we much after getting what we have spent, what we have committed into this project, or getting the promise, what we have been promised, you know, having waited this long, getting this thing fulfilled? That is what women call the angle I'm coming from, and which I know even the ambassador, you know, will also, you know, be telling you anytime you meet with him. Even if you go to you, or you go to the international office, or here, everything we are looking at is disbursement and commitment and fulfillment. So that's why I said for the implementation, just give up. We are talking about 60 or days there about. By June, July, all this whole thing will be a thing of, you know, of joy. Everybody will now see victory at last. For us to keep, you know, going back and forth. To me, I don't believe in having issues like this is what we're having in UAG, and that is keeping us to this very moment. When a leader cannot agree that, okay, let it be that way, and we do things the way it should be, and we all move forward. for the benefit of all, so that we can consider some that are not, they don't have that privilege to be on this platform, and they are going through a lot, and all these are on our tables, and which we have. That's the purpose why we see that most of these things. It's not even because of what you are just saying now. A lot of people are, they are there, they are wallowing in poverty. They cannot even feed, you know, a day square meal. So please, man, let us come put things together and see how this project becomes a reality. Let's drop our feelings, whichever way you think you have been wrong, you know, let's bear with each other. And then for the delay, we are sorry that this whole thing got to this time. Thank God we all know the kind of country we are into and the way things, you know, are in this country, even to get things, to get, you know, within the government circle, just to get a signature, you know how it goes. So please, let's bear with each other. By God's grace, we get to
hello, please, in conclusion, I want to respond to the
sorry, I am a Michael. Let me just come in here briefly, please. Okay, I said this in this is Africa, Mr. Jew. I said it in the last meeting. There must be moderation. We cannot start meeting by 8, 9, and to 12, I'll be after 11. We are saying basically one or two things. If somebody is trying to move a motion, and there are 50 people that have basically the same thing to say, there is no need for repetition. If someone else wants to oppose, and there are 20 people that we also want to oppose, one person has spoken. We don't have to give room for everybody to keep saying basically the same thing. 5 minutes, 3 minutes, whatever your timing is, you let them know 1 minute before the time elapses, you hint them that they have one more minute to go. This was what I said in the last meeting. Do you know I've already slept up, and I woke up to see that the meat is still on our Jesus. So I think you really
the thing is, I just want everybody to digest or bring out everything in their minds.
Because but people can always summarize. You can't give people hours.
I understand.
Hello, Ayama.
Just make it brief. 2 minutes.
Just brief. It's something that one can overlook, but I cannot overlook it because my coordinators, all my people, are being embarrassed in every of their stations, which I'm not happy about. And me carrying a call, I don't want anybody to tarnish the call that is in my hands. And that is why I bring the matter here. Thank you.
Please, Ambassador. I want to know, Ambassador Ayo, please.
I'm with you.
I want to know, you know, this thing you talked about right now, that is June, July. You know, Africans, we are so funny. You know, they've given time of disbursement. Theobarth has given time without a number of disbursement. But when it comes so close to the time, it will bring up an issue that the federal government, ABC, the monkey, ABC, you know, did this, did that. They'll push it again. It's your June, July authentic, sir. And number two, before we wrap up the show, where is your donor? Where is this to ease donor is coming from, sir? What's the name? The donor.
It's okay. Thank you. Let me start from the last question. We're on the cyberspace. If you do that, you make that public, we will. Well, coming back to the date, June, July. I have, our fact to that, which I will also make known to you. But as well as I've given the word, I know everyone, you know, has backed it, and we will smile. Come this time, in July, we'll have this result by God's grace. Thank you, everyone. Please, we are sorry for the delay. Just bear with us. We're in Nigeria, but we know things will get better by God's grace. Thanks and good evening.
All right, authority, do you have any closing remark? Your parting shots, madam.
Thank you, electrifying hitman. I appreciate you for this gesture. Please, we want Ambassador Agidi himself to come up and speak to us. Because we don't expect him to send a representative. So I expect him to come out. I have challenged him in one of the that he should speak to us. if people in Ekiti and other states happen to be here, bad, it's going to be another thing tonight. Let him come out. Let him. He is the one going around to tell people that he wants to empower them. I know what he promised, and I know what he took away from the various locations mm-hmm. where he held this. Let him come out and face us. Thank you.
I think we need to join this meeting to another day to bring bring Baba on the hot seat. Please, ladies and gentlemen, we have to close the show. Honorable AA, legendary AA Musa, do you have anything to say?
I want to appreciate the ambassador. At least he has said sorry for the delay. I'm sorry for other things. Let's hope we will keep him in work. Because if UAAG can come back and say sorry, we'll move forward. So let's give them benefit of doubt. Thank you.
All right. Mr. Michael, are you there?
I'm here.
Hello.
I'm here.
Okay, please. I want to just urge you to just make this recorded fashion to just be available so that we can send it to our people just to calm them down. So God bless you.
Don't worry. We'll do a broadcast on that to all the platforms. We'll send them V-notes regarding this promise to all the state platforms, man. We are giving you the assurance, man. To let them know that very soon, by June, July, things will come up.
Okay. The recording will be available in the next 2 minutes. So when we close the show, you'll get it. So you circulate it. All right. I want to thank everybody for coming. We spent much time. I want to thank the legendary AA Musa for coming, legendary Ngwaghachuku. I believe he has left the platform. Legendary African Mr. Joe, the ambassador Ayo from the UN, and the authority Dr. Princess Madam. Thank you very much for coming. And we got Adekunle, Olusegun, we got Abu EDC. We got a couple of other people here. If I fail to mention your name, don't be offended. We got Kindy Sunday. We got Ambassador Ajibola. I want to thank everybody for coming to the Hot Seat today. Chat show powered by Hit Me Foundation and produced by Emma Michael. All right, we'll be doing this next week. Maybe then the Baba, the director, the professor, ambassador will be on the Hot Seat, the CEO of To He will be on the house. Thank you, everybody, for coming. Good night.
Good night.